St. Joseph College Hostel has a rich history. The whole campus, we had only the hostel. College was in Residency Road. Students used to walk to the Residency Road and come back. So the whole campus had a beautiful playground, and in front of this hostel there was a nice lawn. And students in the evening used to sit and play. But in 2000, the college was shifted to this campus, and the hostel lost the beautiful ground. The college building came. One way it was good for the hostel boys because it was very close to the college. Put one step there in the college, one step back is there in the hostel. Otherwise, we lost the privacy. Then the auditorium came. The hostel lost some more place because again, the hostel there was space for the students to dry their clothes and all that. But when the auditorium came, they lost that also. The hostel became cramped in the two buildings. But in spite of all that, the hostel life has been very rich. Because students from various ethnic groups, various languages and courses, they stay together and they learn a lot.
Hi, my name is Rahul Gabriel Rai. I'm a second year UJP student. I joined the hostel this last year. The hostel has about 118 students and it can contain about a number of 120 students, and I guess that was the reason I couldn't get admission in the first year itself. Being here in this hostel, there are a lot of serious rules that have been imposed on us. One of them being that we have to be back, or you can say the curfew is at 6:30. And to see you're really only very small, my clothes on within you and without you. Being an EJP student, being back at the hostel at 6:30 is quite an issue because we have seminars and classes which go on after 6:30. So to take permission every day is quite a struggle. Other rules that sort of interfere with our college life is the fact that in the morning we're supposed to be up by 6 o'clock and be ready for mass or prayer halls if you are not a Catholic. This in a way is good because it allows us to wake up early and all that, but if you are a student who sort of stays up late night and studies or does your work, it's quite difficult for you to wake up and be present. And there's serious strict actions against those who don't make it to the rules. Being here with 118 students is quite thrilling. There are people from different backgrounds and it's quite an exposure you get here. I'm from Kerala, and the reason that I was sent to Bangalore, or the reason that I chose Bangalore to do my degree in, was because of the exposure I would get here. And this hostel definitely provides me that exposure. I believe that despite many rules being there in the hostel, all of these, they somehow are building steps in our life, and it surely is for our betterment that they impose all these rules.